The Galaxy S26 Ultra Snapdragon chip could be 13% faster than regular version. It's no news that Galaxy S26 Ultra will have the Snapdragon 8 Elite 2 for Galaxy processor. Ahead to debut, a fresh leak shows the clock speeds of the CPU cores, suggesting it might be 13% quicker than the normal edition. If accurate, the Korean business will deliver a big performance improvement in its next-generation premium flagship. Qualcomm is gearing ready to introduce its flagship Snapdragon 8 Elite 2 chip next month. Built on TSMC 3-nanometer node, the processor might debut as the company's most advanced mobile APT yet. According to a source, Afishik Yadav, the normal Snapdragon 8 Elite 2 would contain two cores clocked at 4.19 GHz and six cores at 3.63 GHz. The Galaxy exclusive edition will also retain the same base speed of 3.63 GHz, although frequencies for the two performance cores could be boosted to 4.74 GHz. This means the prime cores of Snapdragon 8 Elite 2 for Galaxy are 550 Hz faster, at least 13%, than the standard ones. The difference between the ordinary Snapdragon 8 Elite and its Galaxy-specific version is 150 MHz, which is a 3.5% bump in peak clock speed. However, the standard 8 Elite chip's main cores run at 4.32 GHz, so it's very shocking that Qualcomm has dropped the base speed of its new chip to 4.19 GHz. The tipster apparently acquired the information from a recent Geekbench listing for the Red Magic 11 Pro. Nonetheless, with a staggering 4.74 GHz frequency on the Galaxy S26 Ultra, consumers should see advantages in day-to-day chores such as browsing and app launches. In the GPU category, the Snapdragon 8 Elite 2 will likely contain the same Adreno 840 GPU at the same speed, so graphics performance should remain consistent across the two types. Alongside the Galaxy S26 Ultra, Samsung is apparently creating the Galaxy S26 Pro and S26 Edge. While the business may equip both devices with Qualcomm's flagship chip, there's rumors that some regions could instead get an in-house Exynos 2600. We shall learn more about this in the following months. Now let's talk more on the Snapdragon 8 Elite 2 and how it will try off next year. So here is everything else we know about it. The Snapdragon 8 Elite, launched last year, was a significant investment for Qualcomm, and it turned out to be a massive success. The strong Oryon cores, paired with 3-nanometer cutting-edge technology, gave huge performance and efficiency advantages. It's still one of the quickest smartphone chipsets. Pushing the constraints even further, Qualcomm is already working on its successor, the Snapdragon 8 Elite 2, and early leaks reveal interesting advancements. The chip is also arriving a month earlier, which means we'll see devices debuting with this chip sooner than ever before. Here's all we know about the Snapdragon 8 Elite 2. Qualcomm will reveal the Snapdragon 8 Elite 2 at the Snapdragon Summit 2025, set to take place on September 23. That's a month earlier than its regular plan, and Qualcomm isn't alone in here. Its main rival, MediaTek, is also apparently pushing up the announcement to display Dimensity 9500 even earlier in September. Not to forget, Apple will also debut its updated iPhones in the same month, powered by a new A19 CPU. So September is going to be an extremely busy month, and I'm quite excited to see how these chips stand up against each other. Although the formal launch is still weeks away, leaks and benchmarks have already revealed various data regarding the forthcoming Snapdragon flagship, as discussed in the following sections. So according to the specifications, Qualcomm will reportedly use TSMC improved 3-nanometer technology for the fabrication of the Snapdragon 8 Elite 2. Several claims also surfaced online claiming a Samsung-made Snapdragon 8 Elite in the works, although it is not ready for mass production just yet, according to a reliable leaker, Digital Chat Station. The second-generation Snapdragon 8 Elite is rumored to contain AIM version 9 architecture, allowing advanced instructions such as SME1 and SVE2. As for the CPU cores, Qualcomm will likely continue to the same core cluster, containing two prime Oryon cores and six performance Oryon cores. Qualcomm will reportedly use the third-generation Oryon CPU cores in the Snapdragon 8 Elite 2 processor. The 8 Elite contains the second-generation Oryon core, whereas the first generation core was used in the Snapdragon X Elite for PC. According to recent reports, the 8 Elite 2 may attain 4.6 GHz of peak frequency for its ordinary edition, and a whopping 4.74 GHz for the 4 Galaxy variation that Samsung will be deploying in the Galaxy S26 series early next year. That's a nice bump from Snapdragon 8 Elite's 4.32 GHz. Along with performance advancements on the 3rd-gen Oryon CPU, will likely provide a considerable performance boost to the forthcoming flagship. The forthcoming Snapdragon 8 Elite 2 is reported to include an improved Adreno 840 GPU with roughly a 30% performance bump. The GPU is rumored to be clocked at up to 1.2 GHz and may feature expanded independent cache from 12 MB to 16 MB for better graphics rendering. It could add support for LPDDR5X/LPDDR6 memory. So, here's a spec sheet based on the leaked details. Snapdragon 8 Elite 2 benchmarks. While there have been no benchmark leaks as yet, trustworthy tipster Digital Chat Station has something to share with us. According to him, Qualcomm's next flagship would attain a single-core score over 4,000 and a multi-core score over 11,000. For reference, the Snapdragon 8 Elite scores roughly 3,000, 100 and 9,800 in single-core and multi-core, respectively. This corresponds to an improvement of roughly 25 to 30% in single-core and 10 to 15% in multi-core for the latest flagship. These are not significant gains, but not less than noteworthy for a year-over-year upgrade. The same source also expects that the 8 Elite 2 could break the 4 million AnTuTu mark. If that's true, that would be an astounding feat for Qualcomm. For reference, the Snapdragon 8 Elite only achieves roughly 2.8 million. There's still a lot we don't know about the Snapdragon 8 Elite 2, notably when it comes to the camera, connection, and NPU enhancements. Hopefully, additional details will emerge soon, and I'll update this video when they do. Next, the Galaxy S26 Ultra, it will probably offer a huge change in design. It is influenced by iPhone 17 Pro. Samsung is supposedly preparing to end a long era, and coupled with Galaxy S26 Ultra, will enter a completely new chapter of its flagship phone design. According to the recent leaks, it plans to finish the move that was already started with S25 Ultra and so put their flags closer to the style of other big manufacturers. The Ultra variants of the series Galaxy, we were used to not just outstanding features and state-of-the-art functions, but from 2022 also in a square look, while cheaper smartphones normally have softened edges. Samsung since released Galaxy S22 Ultra fiercely clung on to sharp edges. This made his flags distinctive at first glance, which was probably also the purpose. But with S25 Ultra there has been a small alteration. The corners are now slightly rounded. And it seems that at the Rogue Galaxy with S26, Samsung wants to accomplish this change entirely, and the edges will be much more rounded. Flag model Galaxy S26 Ultra thus, it will be much more similar to the competition from the front. For example, to mobile phones Pixel 10 Pro or iPhone 17 Pro. This makes them more easily replaceable for less informed users, which is a shame on the one hand, but perhaps this is Samsung's purpose. However, the back should keep the traditional design of the series Galaxy S. He pointed out this modification on the X Network leaker Ice Universe, who generally hits the mark with leaks. Samsung Galaxy S26 Ultra would be more elegant, would be easier to carry in a pocket, and would not risk tearing the fabric owing to rough edges, which many consumers complained about. And after many years of the same design, it would be feasible eventually an obvious alteration. Now the big question is, will the Galaxy S26 Ultra contain a built-in stylus? We've seen various speculations during the summer that indicated Samsung would make substantial improvements to the S26 Ultra S Pen. In late June, sources suggested that Samsung is considering deleting the S Pen Pen to improve the battery size of the Galaxy S26 Ultra. In such a circumstance, Samsung might very well sell the S Pen as an accessory, but the pen would have to be carried separately like on previous generation Galaxy Z Fold phones. A further report in mid-June indicated that Samsung was considering deleting the S26 Ultra's digitizer to make place for Qi2 magnets on the back of the phone that would enable wireless charging like the Pixel 10 series Bible. The removal of the digitizer would mean that Samsung would abandon the S Pen or build a stylus that doesn't need a digitizer layer to work. On the other side, a leak in mid-July indicated that Samsung wasn't happy with the S Pen performance after removing the digitizer, and that the display layer will continue in place to support S Pen pen experiences. That rumor made no mention of Samsung withdrawing the stylus. It didn't detail the Galaxy S26 Ultra's design either. All these rumors indicate that Samsung was testing multiple prototypes ahead of starting production. Samsung will debut the Galaxy S26 series in early 2026. And it operates on Samsung's latest One UI 8 software, which includes a range of features aimed at boosting usability and customization. This software upgrade, scheduled to trickle out to older devices like the S25 series, features many important enhancements. Advanced watermarking options allow users to personalize their photographs with unique branding. Vivid photo enhancing techniques that produce crisper, more vivid photographs. A noteworthy feature of the S26 Ultra is its integration with Google Photos' Gemini-powered AI editing features. This cooperation enables users to modify images using natural language instructions, whether through text or speech. Tasks such as cropping, altering lighting, or adding filters become straightforward and accessible, offering professional-grade editing capabilities to everyday users. This seamless marriage of AI and user-friendly design ensures that the S26 Ultra appeals to both casual photographers and creative professionals. And it will also shine in energy efficiency, thanks to its sophisticated display technology and streamlined hardware. The Flex Magic Pixel display decreases battery consumption while retaining high performance, allowing users to enjoy extended screen time without regular recharging. This focus on energy conservation is particularly valuable for consumers who rely on their devices for work, leisure, and communication throughout the day. Complementing this efficiency is the S26 Ultra's state-of-the-art battery technology, which ensures consistent performance even under intensive usage. By promoting sustainability, Samsung fits with industry trends toward eco-friendly innovation. The Galaxy S26 Ultra not only matches the expectations of today's smartphone customers, but also displays a commitment to decreasing environmental impact. So stay tuned for more updates and information on the highly anticipated Galaxy S26 and witness the future of smartphones from Samsung. See you in my next video. Peace out.